Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is September 25th, 2012, at 12:33 a.m. The purpose of this video right here is that, as you guys know, that I was arrested and charged with terror plots. And a federal judge was included in though as one of my victims, and I was held in jail for 64 days. And when I came out, when I was in jail, they sold my house, the bank, Wells Fargo and US Bank and MERS. They arrested me on May 1st, then foreclosed on my home on May 2nd and sold it at auction. And they held me in jail for 64 days. However, when I came out, they offered me $7,500 to get out my house within a week. And I don't play that. I refused that. And so they gave me, on August 1st, 2012, they gave me a order, a 72-hour order to vacate the premises in 72 hours. I let the 72 hours expire, then I filed a lawsuit in the Brockton District Court, Superior Court, I sued some of the parties for like 34 point something million dollars, and I sued the banks for 2% of their earnings. And I wanted to go to the people if I do win. However, people, as it so happened, a federal judge is right smack in the middle of this case. The federal judge was at the forefront of me being arrested and charged. Even though the federal judge never made a complaint himself, he was made on his behalf by others. With or without his consent, I don't know. But I was charged with basically intimidating, threatening, stalking, you know, federal judge. And no bill of particulars, so we don't really know which one it is, to tell the truth. You know, so the point being, people, I filed a lawsuit claiming that the foreclosure was unlawful and that my arrest and incarceration was a violation of my constitutional rights, my right to free speech and what's not, because I was arrested because of my videos, and because of my videos, basically my videos, and because of the lawsuit that I filed against all the banks and against Barack Obama and all 50 governors and George Bush. So those are the real issues why I was arrested, because the federal marshal came to investigate me. So those are the issues why I was really arrested. They were really behind it. They wanted to shut me up because I was telling you guys what was going on in the federal court, what they were doing to me in the federal court. They wanted to shut me up because I filed a lawsuit against all the banks and I basically won, but they cheated. So now, as I said, I filed a lawsuit in the Brockton court, and the defendants removed the case from the Brockton court to the federal court. Because, you know, the same federal judge ruled against me before. He ruled against me in the case I filed against Barack Obama, George Bush, and all 50 governors. And he ruled against me in the case I filed against the banks. He said my mother committed the fraud, and I was angry at him for falsely accusing my mother. So I started talking out against him on the internet. And I spoke out harshly against him, even though I had a deep respect for him because he pushed me to fight. I still was angry at him because he disrespected my mother. I mean, people, come on. Over 6 million people lost their homes because of fraud. And out of the 6 million, my mother committed the fraud. It doesn't make no sense. The evidence doesn't even support it. So I was angry at him for speaking against my mother, even when the evidence points differently. So I stood on my First Amendment right and I spoke out. And so now the defendant in the new case now, so the judge ruled against me and gave the bank my house. So we committed fraud against the banks. Me, my mother have never even been to college. But yet she was able to dupe these university graduate professionals. But anyway, that's beside the point. The point is, people, I sued them for false arrest, libel and slander and all that stuff. False accusation and all that stuff, right? And they removed the case back to the same federal judge, hoping that he will give them favorable treatment and throw up my case again. However, that federal judge, being an honorable man, I guess, now he's being honorable and being the true person I really met. Because when I really met him, I mean, he impressed me, man. He was so honorable. He impressed me. So now he now being his honorable self once again, he recruits himself from the case. And I asked for the case to be sent back to the district court. But however, now the case is in front of Justice William G. Young. And people, I know Justice William G. Young, he's sympathetic towards homeowners who have been victimized by Wall Street. And I have faith in justice. However, people, I have spoken harshly against his colleague. And I am in kind of a fear that because of what I have said, because I have exercised my First Amendment right, that this judge is going to rule against me, even though I may have a legitimate point. And at the same time, I don't have no fear because I know if this judge rule against me based on prejudice because I spoke out against his colleague, then that's on him, because personal responsibility is a keynote of freedom. Also, chaos is a necessary stage in the process of change. Those quotes I took from, you know, the handbooks of the new paradigm. So each one have a personal responsibility if we want change in this world. So we could stick in the same mud that we've been in for 2,000 plus years, or we could move on. You know, so what I'm saying is that I hope that Justice William G. Young will not be prejudiced against me because of what I've said against his colleague. And this is my case based on that judicial prejudice. Other than that, I have no fear. So my message to Justice William G. Young is, please, sir, do not throw up my case based on any type of prejudice towards me. I ask that you judge this case based on the merits of the complaint and not to be bamboozled by the defendants. And I hope you don't take offense by me making this video, but if I don't tell the public what's going on, I feel that I'll be cornered and I'll be taken advantage of, because I stand alone. Me and my God, the Son, Ra. I stand alone with Ra, and no one is watching. And when no one watches, when the cats are where the mice will play. So I make this video, sir, not because I want to put you out on YouTube, but because I just want you to do the right thing. And I'm asking you, I'm pleading to the world that the world watch what goes on. October 11, 2012 is our day in court, and I just want people to know what's going on, because I fear that you are going to take advantage of me if no one is watching. And I hope, sir, I have faith that justice will prevail, and I have faith that you is a just man. I cannot prejudge you, but all I ask is that you judge this case based on the merits of the complaint, not on the legal voodoo of the defendant. And here's a message to you, a blast from the past. So, Justice William G. Young, this is a message to you, and I hope that you honor it. One love, one heart, one destiny for all true humanity.
The question before the House is one of awful moment to this country. For my own part, I consider it as nothing less than a question of freedom or slavery. And in proportion to the magnitude of the subject, ought to be the freedom of the debate. It is only in this way that we can hope to arrive at truth and fulfill the great responsibility which we hold to God and our country. Should I keep back my opinions at such a time through fear of giving offense, I should consider myself as guilty of treason toward my country, and of an act of disloyalty towards the majesty of heaven, which I revere above all earthly kings.
Say bye-bye to the camera. Say bye-bye to the people. Say bye-bye to the people. You're not gonna say nothing?
Cool.
Hey, people.